everyone. Today we are going to discuss the next reagent, that is Raney Nickel. Okay, in last lecture we have studied about selenium dioxide, DCC, as an oxidizing reagent. In the today's lecture we are going to discuss the next reducing reagent, that is Raney Nickel. First of all, in this lecture we are going to discuss, first point is about preparation. Second point is about its applications. In this applications, number of applications, and due to the under such conditions, how nickel affects the double bond, how nickel affects the functional groups, and so on. These all the criteria we have to see in this lecture. So let us start this lecture as here. First is preparation. In 1927, the scientist Ramsay, Murray Raney discovered this reagent, that is Raney Nickel. Okay, in this Raney Nickel reagents, here in this reagent hydrogen is less bound to nickel. Okay, now how it is formed, how Raney Nickel is formed? See here, according to Murray Raney, scientist, the preparation of Raney Nickel catalyst is done in this way. First, here in the alloy of nickel aluminium alloy, he added a solution of NaOH, and that solution to be a purely cold, that is a ice cold solution of NaOH. Then it is added to nickel aluminium alloy, and the mixture is heated at 120 degrees Celsius at about 2 to 3 hours. Okay, what is the first step here? That is, in this nickel aluminium alloy, the super cold solution of a sodium hydroxide is added slowly about in 2 hours, and the mixture is heated at 120 degrees Celsius at about 2 to 3 hours. After completion of 2 to 3 hours, again this ice cold solution of NaOH is again added to the mixture. And the mixture is heated at 120 degrees. Till all the hydrogens, that is H2, is given out. Now what step is remaining one? When hydrogen is given out as a H2 gas, here in this mixture, excess of NaOH, whatever may be added, is decanted out. Instead of NaOH, is decanted by use of filter, and then after 2 to 3 hours we get a solid catalyst called as Raney Nickel. This Raney Nickel catalyst is prepared. Now we are going to see its applications. Number of applications are available in the case of this Raney Nickel. First of all, we will discuss it about, in short, we can take the brief shortcut of this. First is, that is, in the reduction of alkenes. First point is what about reduction of alkenes. In these alkenes, we are going to discuss first, that is carbon carbon double bond. Okay, next 1,3-butadiene. Okay, next formation of next benzene compound. Here these compounds we can take in consideration. Now second point is the reduction of naphthalene. When reduction of naphthalene is taken at the temperature range 100 to 150, what happens? And 150 to 200 is what happens here. Okay, we have to take in consideration. Again, next point is reduction of phenol. Reduction of phenols, what happens? Then reduction of aromatic ethers, what happens? Reduction of cyano compounds, okay? Reduction of nitro compounds, reduction of thioethers, okay? And lastly, we have to discuss the reduction of halo compounds. Reduction of halo compounds. And last but one is, that is the reduction of a triglycerides, that is the conversion of an oil into a glycerin. Up to this we have to consider in this lecture. Okay, now let us start with reduction of an alkenes. Okay, see here. In this reduction we have to consider the three cases. Okay, see here, three cases. First is reduction of an alkenes. Example of is of butadiene. Okay, next example is of benzene. Okay, what happens? By using the Rayleigh nickel catalyst, nickel reduces this alkenes along with this. Reduction is carried out using Rayleigh nickel. It produces these double bonds and converts it into a alkane. Formation of a alkane. What is this? That is CH2 double bond CH2. Here this bond is fused and there is addition of a hydrogen plus H2, there is formation of this, that is CH3 single bond this CH3. That is, in short, here we can write it as, that is CH3 bond CH3. That is, double bond is fused into a single bond. That is formation of a ethane. Formation of an ethane. Now, considering the second example, that is butadiene. 1,3-butadiene, see here the structure of this. That is, this is 1,3-butadiene. Okay, now 1,3-butadiene. Simply, in each step, we have to glue one double bond at a step by using a Rayleigh nickel catalyst. Nickel produces one double bond at a time. Therefore, there is formation of this. Okay, again nickel, Rayleigh nickel catalyst. Okay, it reduces to this. Okay, now what is this here? 1,2,3,4. That is formation of a butane. CH3, CH2, CH2, and CH3. Normal butane. Formation of a butane takes place when Rayleigh nickel catalyst is used in case of a 1,3-butadiene. That is, cleaving of two double bonds and formation of a alkane takes place. Okay, now the next example is of benzene. In case of benzene, here, what is the structure of benzene? Already all of you know, this structure of a benzene. Okay, what happens here? How many double bonds are here? 3 double bonds. Therefore, by use of reduction, we have to use RaNaDK as a catalyst. How many hydrogens are here? It is plus 3 H2. But plus 3 H2, these are used in a step by step. Here, when we have to use it, first is H2, there is formation of this step. Again, we have to use plus H2, RaNaDK, okay. Formation of this step, okay. And again on plus H2, RaNaDK, there is formation of a cyclohexane. The name of the compound is cyclohexane. And by means of RaNaDK catalyst, benzene can be reduced to or converted into a cyclohexane. This is up to a alkene. Also, one more factor is that is conversion of, like benzene, another compound is that is the naphthalene. In the naphthalene, what happens here? See here, this is the structure of naphthalene. My chalk is so a this is the structure of naphthalene. Here 100 to 150 degrees Celsius RaNaDK and 150 to 200 degrees Celsius RaNaDK. What happens here? At a temperature range 100 to 150 degrees Celsius, RaNaDK reduces this naphthalene to tetraene. This is called as tetraene. And above 150 to 200, there is formation of a decaline. See here the structure, decaline. Decaline. That is, at the temperature range 100 to 150 degrees Celsius, in naphthalene, one of the ring is only glued. That is, two double bonds are glued. Therefore, formation of tetraene. But above the temperature is raised, all the double bonds are totally, five double bonds are converted into single bonds, so this formation of a decaline is precipitous. Now, the next criteria is, that is the production of a phenol. Production of phenol. Phenol is carried out in a first is partial way and second is a full way. Partial reduction RaNaDK and full reduction. Full reduction. It is at 120 to 150 degrees Celsius RaNaDK plus H2. Okay. Now, what is the structure of phenol? Here, I am writing here phenol structures. Okay, that is from here. This is the structure of a phenol. Okay, this is OH. Okay, now in this partial reduction, there is formation of an this derivative that is called as imine. And here also enamine. Formation of this, and again this is unconverted into a formation of a cyclohexane. But in the range of a typical temperature like 120 to 150 degrees Celsius, the full reduction of phenol is takes place and there is formation of a cyclohexanol. There is formation of a cyclohexanol. What is the difference between the reduction of these phenols with the different temperature ranges? First is partial reduction, formation of cyclohexanone, and here formation of a cyclohexanol. Okay, now in here the next point is that reduction of aromatic ethers. Reduction of aromatic ethers. Ethers. Aromatic ethers. Like the example of here, this is Cl, Ar, O, R. Here, nickel, Ra-ni nickel, that at least cleaves the bond between aromatic compound and this aliphatic compound through the oxygen linkage, and thus there is formation of a aryl alkane and simple open chain alkanes. This formation of this is and this alkane. Okay, now similar case is obtained in the case of a acyl halides, that is ArCOCl, that is aryl acyl halides, by using this is myacyl halides, that is Ra-ni nickel catalyst. It fuses this Cl by H, that is here ArCO and H. Okay, formation of a benzyl group. Aryl acyl halides. Now, next reduction is of, that is the reduction of cyano compounds. Cyano or nitrile compounds. Reduction of nitriles or cyanides. RCN, Ra-ni nickel catalyst plus H2, formation of this RCOH. Okay, and Ra-ni nickel catalyst under pressure. Under pressure, Ra-ni nickel catalyst plus H2, that is RCCHNH, which is again undergoes hydrogenation, that is on reduction formation of RCH2NH2. It is formation of a primary amine. And here the formation of a carboxylic acid. Sorry, CN group is converted into, CN group is converted into a CHO group, not a COH group, because COH group is converted on this spot. CN group is hydrolysis then COH group is converts here, and then here reduction process is what? There is formation of an aldehyde. Formation of an aldehyde takes place. That is when this cyano group is present over nickel. Ra-ni nickel catalyst simply catalyzes CN by a CHO group. But under pressure, the condition will change again. The formation of the product is gets changed. Okay, now reduction of halides. Reduction of halides. See here, ArX reduction, Ra-ni nickel. Formation of a benzene by H. Okay. Reduction of or desulfonation here. Desulfonation reaction. It is when benzene ring carries SO3H group benzene sulfonic acid here. So this SO3H group can be cleaved by dynamical catalyst and the formation of a benzene takes place. Here also, when a halide group is present, nickel selectively cleaves this halide as a leaving group and thereby replacing it by a hydrogen. Therefore, there is formation of a benzene. Okay, now desulfurization. Next reaction is about desulfurization. Thioethers, thioamides can be converted into reduced to H. For example, RSH, R dash, okay, R SH not A, R, R S R dash may be converted into plus S, H2 reduction reaction here, formation. Now next reaction is the desulfurization. Rarely nickel eliminates sulfur from the functional group and it replaces this sulfur by a hydrogen atoms, as it is in thioethers. First is in thioethers, thiones, thioamides, nickel replaces thiol by an hydrogen. Okay, reaction is like this. That is R S R dash gives rise to nickel hydrogen, replaces here. That is R H plus R dash H. Here the formation of an alkene. Okay. Another example, you know, thioamides, that is RCSNHR, nickel hydrogen, conversion of this is into RCH2NHR. Okay, in this way, rarely nickel replaces whatever may be with thiols or sulfurs by means of a hydrogen. The last application is of, that is hardening of an oil. See here. Of an oil. By using rare nickel as a catalyst, it reduces the triglycerides, that is a oil, into a conversion of a ghee. The reaction is as follows: CH2OCO CN H2N minus 1, CHOCO CN H2N minus 1, and CH2OCO CN H2N minus 1. Here temperature range is about 150 to 200 degrees Celsius. Nickel as a catalyst, a conversion of an oil into a ghee. That is, this is a unsaturated oil, or triglycerides are converted into a glycerides by means of a rare nickel as a catalyst. See here the reaction as it is: CH2OCO CN H2N minus 1, CHOCO CN H2N minus 1, and CH2OCO CN H2N minus 1. Thus there is formation of a unsaturated triglycerides. Okay, Thus, we have here considered the use of a rhenanical catalyst in a number of functional groups. The last one is, that is the reduction of a nitro group. Simple reaction here, reduction of NO2 group. Here, RNO2 converts rhenanical as a catalyst. Here, conversion of a NO2 group by a NH2 group. Reduction process is carried out here by means of rhenanical, and thus we have here concluded all the functional groups, that is from alkene, phenyl, benzene, phenol, cyanides, then our nitriles, ethers, acyl chlorides, only halides, thiols, and the conversion of a unsaturated triglycerides into an ethene. Thus we have concluded here the use of a rhenanical as a catalyst in a application level. I hope that all of you understand this video very much. If there are any problems, please ask me on group. Thank you.